The prescription opioid epidemic is a public health emergency. An estimated 11.4 million people have misused opioids. More than 42,000 people died from opioid overdoses in 2016 and 2017. In recognition of National Substance Abuse Prevention Month and leading up to the National Prescription Drug Takeback Day, this Saturday, Mayo Clinic is releasing the results of its annual Mayo Clinic Health Checkup Survey on October 23rd with its focus on America's perceptions. And joining us now live is Dr. Holly Geyer with the Mayo Clinic. Dr. Geyer, this is the Mayo Clinic's fifth national health checkup, and it addresses the opioid epidemic. What are some of the key findings?
Well, thank you so much for the opportunity to talk on this incredibly important topic. You know, it's hard to turn on the TV today without hearing about the opioid epidemic, and the Mayo Clinic National Healthcare Survey is essentially a litmus test of the views in society on, you know, related topics to healthcare and consumer problems. Things like the opioid epidemic, and the results of this survey were just fascinating. We learned that communication strategies between providers and patients are certainly not adequate at this point, and patients are really looking for alternatives to opioid therapies. So we took this as a checkpoint for Mayo Clinic and for the rest of the healthcare industry to really start addressing this on a more important and aggressive basis.
Mm-hmm. So most Americans then would prefer an alternative to opioids, is what you're saying, for pain relief?
That study statistic shocked me. The data came back that 90%+ of patients would rather choose a non-opioid alternative after a surgical procedure. You know, amongst those items listed, they wanted physical therapy, they wanted acupuncture, they want scheduled Tylenol, scheduled ibuprofen. And surprisingly, the American public must be fairly well educated at this point because those items work. We want to offer them if patients are interested.
Mm-hmm. But The problem is still an epidemic, and how did the survey come up with information about how the epidemic is being attacked?
So the survey wasn't so much to understand how we should, or I should say, how the healthcare industry is responding to the epidemic. It's more along the lines of what patients are looking for from an epidemic standpoint. And we identified a couple of things. Number one, I think patients are looking perhaps for more communication with providers. The study identified that only a third of patients are talking with their providers about how to dispose of opioids. Only a third are talking with their doctors about alternatives to opioid therapies. And the majority aren't talking about other ways to manage symptoms. So I think it's very important that we as providers take the other side of the chair and start listening to patients, start considering what alternatives are available and offering those as appropriate for specific conditions. Mm-hmm.
You brought up a good point, Dr. Geyer, about disposing of opioid medication. Is that a big concern in the survey as well?
Huge concern. You know, the Center for Disease Control did a study a couple of years ago and identified that well over 50% of medications that are making it on the market illicitly are coming from friends and family members as being either given to them or stolen. We know that from a survey done at Mayo Clinic just a couple years ago, the vast majority of leftover prescriptions that we're giving to patients are sitting in medicine cabinets for prolonged periods. On top of that, patients are inappropriately offering it to other friends and family members. So mm-hmm. Get rid of them as soon as you are done taking them. If pain is gone, those need to be destroyed. Take back days are a great way to do that.
All right, good advice, Dr. Holly Geyer.
Another option includes destroying them. That might be destroying them with drugs, other medications.
Mm-hmm. All right, Dr. Holly Geyer with the Mayo Clinic, thank you so much for being with us. Have a great day.